Brent Pecknold and his team are ready for another exciting season of ECAC hockey. They've developed quite a national reputation while playing the likes of Harvard and Dartmouth and Cornell and Yale. And watching a game here at the TD Bank Sports Center, even the casual fan gets a little bit wild.
You know, the crowd's great. The students are just awesome. You know, the home games are great. It's a big advantage for us, as it is for everyone. Everyone plays well at home.
The place absolutely erupts, you know, when a goal is scored or after a game. So, I mean, you know, there's no better feeling than that.
It's crazy. It's very enjoyable to play here. And I don't know, it's hard to explain, but when your adrenaline's pumping out there on the ice, it's totally different.
It's certainly enjoyable. It makes our lives a lot easier, and it pumps us up maybe when we're down or had a bad shift or whatnot. But, you know, the excitement, the adrenaline that gets going when this place is rocking, it's indescribable.
It gives us a lot of energy, and we can feed off that. And certainly it's a big home ice advantage.
That home ice advantage will be huge this season, as Rand Pecknold has recruited 13 freshmen to this year's team.
There's a lot of energy in the dressing room, and on paper it's a great class. You know, certainly we've got to wait and start playing some games and see how they do, but we're very excited about this class, and it should keep us in good shape for the next 4 years.
We have 13 new freshmen this year: Darcy Oaks, Reese Rollheiser, and Jeremy Longloy. All three of them led their leagues last year in scoring. And hopefully they can step up.
That's what's exciting. They bring a lot of enthusiasm to the rink every day, and you know, they're excited to get going here.
I mean, obviously at the beginning of the year we're going to have our ups and downs as a decor, but you know, eventually they're going to find their strides and, you know, work their way into the lineup, and you know, hopefully be good contenders down the road.
I think we're going to struggle a little bit out of the gate because we're so young, but the guys will get up to speed pretty quickly, and we do have some good veterans. And once they figure out what it takes at this level, I think we'll be pretty good.
Over the past few seasons, the Bobcats have started out strong, but lost their momentum as the season wore on.
You know, I wish I knew exactly what happened, but it has happened the last couple of years. We've been great mid part of the season, the middle third of the season, we've been awesome. And then we run out of gas a little bit at the end of the year.
I think we're just gonna have to clear our minds and just work through that. I think we're gonna have to be in better shape, which I think we've done so far through the summer.
This year we'll try to do some things a little bit differently, maybe give them some days off in February. But we tried that last year too, and it didn't work. So I think a lot of it is the leadership. You know, we need our captains to keep the guys on focused and on track and hungry. And I think if we get that leadership this year, I think we'll be fine.
I mean, everyone is on the same page, and you know, we have a great leader, John Mark. And you know, he's gonna make sure everyone's in check every day, every practice.
Yeah, it's a big responsibility, but I think you know, myself and Juan, like, we want that kind of pressure.
He'll do a great job as a captain. I'm not worried about that. I think the more important thing is, you know, we need not just a couple guys to wear A's and be good assistant captains, but you need, you know, a nucleus of 6 or 7 or 8 guys that do the right thing when no one's watching.
You want other guys following you by example, and I mean, whatever happens off the ice will happen on the ice. So you want to just show good leadership.
Because it's real easy for kids to do the right thing when guys are watching them and the coaches are there. But we need to make sure that we have leadership when the coaches aren't around. I think that's really probably the most important thing.
Doing the right thing all the time is a big part of building solid character both on and off the ice.
The more I do this and the longer I've been in it, the more and more you realize that talent is certainly important, but the character is a big factor. And we know that already, but you got to have good kids. You got to have kids that will go through a wall for you, go through a wall for their teammates. And we certainly have focused more and more on that every year, and it really does make a difference.
Recruiting players with impressive talent and character means looking all over the country and many times beyond.
We go hard in the East. We go hard in Minnesota and the Midwest, and definitely have done very well in British Columbia and Alberta, Ontario over the years. But it all depends. You know, things change in cycles. You know, we're going hard on some Eastern kids right now, and maybe we'll land some Connecticut and Massachusetts and Rhode Island kids. So it just depends. We'll go wherever we can to find the right player and the right fit academically too.
Finding that well-rounded student athlete for the hockey program is the key to their ongoing success.
I think initially when I started, I was all about talent and certainly making sure they were good students. And now it's talent, good or great students, and then great character, and you know, coming from good family backgrounds, and it just makes everybody's life easier. Mine as a coach, and our players too, they have a better experience when you're surrounded, you know, by good kids. And I think right now our culture in our locker room, it's a great group of guys.
The Bobcats are a very young team, but Billy, there's a lot of high expectations for this group.
Well, it should be a great season. Let's send it back down to Jamie, who I think is on a Mount Carmel campus.
All right, gentlemen, coming up, we'll check out how the Quinnipiac men's basketball team plans on reaching the postseason. But first, here's a look at the upcoming Quinnipiac hockey games on NESN.